behavior, and eventually a behavior, a routine, becomes a habit. So guess what we have? We have a whole lot of things that we do every single day to be successful. Let's go back to my 97 superachievers. Do you think they have a powerful success habit set? You betcha. They do what they need to do when they need to do it. They have an educational mindset. You know what's so amazing? While I was sitting interviewing these people, do you know what they were doing to me? They were interviewing me. They wanted to learn from me. Like you. And that's the difference. They're like a sponge. They want knowledge. Because what does knowledge do? Question, is knowledge power? No, it's not. Yeah, I'm sure there's a laptop somewhere connected to the internet, right? Does that laptop have access to every bit of human knowledge that ever existed? Well, pretty close. Yeah, listen, there's a lot of stuff on Google, guys, let's be honest. How successful is that laptop? So yes, it's knowledge. But it's the ability to take that knowledge, organize it, in other words, turn it into a useful format, and then take the right action. Why do I say the right action? Imagine, who knows those redwood trees in America? They make our marula trees look like babies. They're huge. Imagine I had one of those and I had a sharpened axe. And I chopped that tree 5 times with my sharpened axe. Could I eventually get the tree to fall over? But how about I take the same action, but this time I have a ball-peen hammer. And it looks the same. What's going to happen to the tree? Big hole. So yes, it's action. But the most important thing is the right action. And now I hear you say, oh my goodness, all the stuff you just told me, I've got these gifts, I've got to use all these gifts, and now I've got to take the right action. How do I know? Easy. It's called measure performance. In other words, remember I wanted to lose weight? Now I want to lose weight, so I get on the scale once. And then on the 31st of December, the next year, I get on the scale and I go, one chance of working. But how about if I knew my measurements and I went, I would like to lose 12 kilograms and I get negative goals off, but for argument's sake. 12. I get on the scale every month. 12 times as much chance. But how about if I did it every week? 52 times. What about every day? Because every day, if I lose 12 kilograms, oh, my math is amazing. 75 grams a day. If I get on the scale, you see, this is how I measure. Am I hitting with a ball-peen hammer or am I hitting with an axe? I get on the scale day number one. Oops. I've gained 50 grams. No problem. I've got 364 more days. Okay. Drink more water. Eat less fat. Eat more fat. Walk further. Park it off. You understand? Change it. Get on the scale the next day. Whoopee kaya. 50 down. Not 75. 75. 75. 75. 75. 12 kilos. So it's the right actions. How do I know it's the right actions? I measure them. I evaluate them. I test them. Quick pop quiz. What are your three gifts? Imagination. Don't have one. What can't you imagine? No thing. What's your second gift? That's part of the wealth plan. That's part of the wealth plan. Perseverance is a fourth gift. Well, the second gift is the ability, the cognitive ability to build a plan that will take you to that imagined future, right? And then, the secret gift? Google. Search. Engine. Right? So we have an internal Google search engine which we program with our dreams, our goals, and our vision, which comes from our imagination. And then all we have to do, who said perseverance? All we have to do is revisit our childhood. Remember that childhood where you fell down and got up and fell down and got up and what happened? We need to persevere. And anything becomes possible. But of course we have to then say, we need to write our vision down. We need to have what? Absolute belief that we can. We need to commit. Because as we grow ourselves through learning, we become more competent, more confident, greater belief. As our belief grows and we take consistent action, we form habits. The habits allow us to constantly take what? The right actions. The right actions are chopping the tree with a sharpened axe. How do I know they're the right actions? Measure them. How often?
Twice a year.
Once? Yeah. No! Daily. Because the more often I measure them, the sooner I will realize whether I'm hitting the tree with a ball-peen hammer or with a sharpened axe. Well done. Thank you.